How to navigate Azure Data Studio. By the end of this video, you will be able to identify the various components within Azure Data Studio and will know how and when to use them. Prerequisites to working with Azure Data Studio include having it downloaded on your machine and being connected to the Cisco Admin VPN. When you launch Azure Data Studio, you will see a black bar along the left-hand side, and this is where you will find the various functionalities available within Data Studio. So if we hover over the first icon, we'll see that this is where all the connections live. We have another video linked below, which covers how to connect to the VPN and to Rosie Replica, which is a near real-time read-only copy of the Rosie production data. For this quick navigation video, we will assume a connection has been made. So when we click on the connections icon, this new panel opens up and is called the Object Explorer. In here, we will see that our connection to the P301 Easy server, which refers to Rosie Replica, is live because of this green little circle. If we expand the dropdown, we'll see the various objects within the server. Based on the tables we see here, we can create a new query by clicking on this icon. This generates a control window in which we can enter in our code. This query will extract all the rows and columns from the table sys province, and then we can run it by connecting to the server. At the bottom of the screen, we will see the results. Along the blue bar at the bottom, we will see the number of rows the query generated, along with the time it took to retrieve the results. In this case, it took less than a fraction of a second to retrieve the result. Along the right-hand side, we have a few more options for exporting your results. For instance, it can be exported as a CSV, Excel, JSON, Markdown, or XML file. There are also options to visualize your data using the chart icon or the visualizer. This visualizer is useful to get a graphical representation of the data, but for more complex visuals that can be shared with other users, we suggest using Power BI. The next icon along the black bar is the search feature. One use for this feature could be to find and replace a value in your query. For instance, let's say we have a really long query and want to find all the occurrences of the word province, and we want to replace it with the word person. We can find and replace all occurrences at the click of a button. The next icon covers notebooks. These allow you to create and share documents containing live code, visualizations, and narrative text. So let's say you have a number of queries within one file, but want to organize them to make them more user-friendly. This would be a use case for notebooks. For instance, this SQL file looks really busy and is hard to read, but by exporting it to a notebook, you will see that it's easier to read and run the queries. You will also notice the option to change the kernel at the top, which allows you to change the language you are coding in. And pressing the play icon next to the code cells will run the query, and results will be located in the same cell block. You also have the same functionality as before, so you can export the results from here as well. The next icon is the Explorer, and this is where you can create your own local workspace by adding a folder for easy access. Azure Data Studio allows you to save not just queries, but also Markdown, text, and CSV files in your folders. If it's a Markdown file, it will show up in notebooks with proper formatting. You can then link out to external documentation and consolidate everything in the folders where you're running queries. For instance, by selecting Open Folder and selecting a folder, I can now transition easily between the files from the folder. The next icon is Source Control, which is used for more advanced Data Studio users who already have a Git repository they can connect to. From here, you can commit, pull, push changes directly from Data Studio. Finally, we have Extensions, which consists of a marketplace of additional features that you can add to improve your Data Studio experience. And that's it. You can now navigate around Azure Data Studio.